Last night, the aria for Best Dance Release went to
Rufus Du Sol.
But today, everyone was talking about this runner-up.
Jolyon Petch for Dreams.
Petch's Fleetwood Mac reimagining has been getting play everywhere, but it's more than a remix. The Stevie Nicks vocals were impressively recreated by Perth singer Reigan Derry. And while her peers were walking the red carpet, Derry was on the couch, dropping this bombshell on Instagram.
Sitting at home watching the ARIA Awards, Jolyon Petch released Dreams without my consent and without written agreement.
Derry claims she had a verbal agreement with Petch for 10% of any master licensing fees and that she provided her recording as a demo only for a fee of $300.
So essentially a demo is like an unfinished manuscript of a book. Using somebody's demo vocals for the final version of a song is kind of like posting an unedited, unfinished manuscript online.
Derry says if the song was to be released, there would have needed to be another agreement. Instead, she claims Petch made a deal without her and left her name off the credits. But Petch disputes Derry's version of events.
At no time have I ever received an invoice from her that stated demo. Reagan was never concerned with any of these covers, never asked to be credited, and only in the past 7 weeks has Reagan raised it with me with the success of Dreams, and well after I had paid Reagan what was agreed upon last year.
Petch's label, Tomorrow Music, formerly Ministry of Sound, says it was told the two artists and their legal teams had worked things out, and that it's disappointed to hear that's not the case.
The Australian music industry is so small, it's very difficult to make a noise about an injustice without being that artist that gets a black check against their name.
Derry says the dispute has cost her $8,000 in legal fees, and that due to the pandemic, she's had to make money cleaning Airbnbs. So is this a misunderstanding, something more sinister, or just typical music industry behaviour laid bare?
Jennifer Tutte is an entertainment lawyer and joins us now. So, Jen, obviously we don't know all of the facts in this case, and cases do turn on facts, but just based on what we've seen generally, does Reagan seem to have a case?
Yeah, well, there's always two sides to every story, as you know, in a dispute. So if Reagan's side of the story is correct, my view is that she would have be the copyright owner in her vocal recordings that have been used on this remix. She would also have moral rights in her performance and in the copyright work in the vocal recordings. And because of this, she potentially has a copyright infringement and moral rights infringement claim against the artist.
Jen, Petch released a statement today basically saying that he's been trying to work with Reagan. At no stage was it considered a demo in his opinion and her opinion, according to him. So basically he's saying she didn't seem to have a problem until there was great success associated with this song. Does that make a difference?
I don't think so. So if Reagan actually has the legal rights in the song that she claims to have, whether or not the song's successful, it doesn't really matter. If Reagan's claims actually are correct, then actually having a bigger commercial hit is actually more of a problem for Petch, because if this did go to court and she was awarded damages, Petch could potentially have to pay her a lot more damages because the song's been more successful. Yeah.
I've never said this before, Jennifer, but I actually did the vocals on In the Shallows.
Lady did you? Gaga. Love that song.
Yeah, well, oh there you go. I should actually zip up now. Lady Gaga will be on the phone and with her lawyers.
Have you seen any money for that? Any?
Not a cent. Not a cent. Anyway, this is not about me.
What's with the merch?
You never surprised me, Pete.
Thank you, Jennifer. But, artists are generous people by nature. They're often helping each other out with their various projects, perhaps even more generous and lawyers, no offence. But what would your advice be to artists to actually protect themselves in the future?
So my big number one rule is always get your agreement in writing. Sending a text message, sending a social media DM and trying to work out a contract that way is just not the way to go. I think what we've seen and the biggest takeaway from this dispute is that the artist didn't clearly agree in writing what their agreement was at the start. And what's happened is this song has been released and is now massive and has been nominated for an ARIA Award. And, yeah, they just don't know how to do a deal, because obviously it's successful and when money's involved, it's harder to reach an agreement. So get it in writing. Get it in writing.
Jen, thanks for your time.
No worries. Thanks. Bye.